There's this mindset that, oh my God, who knew 10 cent beer night was a bad idea? To that point, nobody, because it wasn't.
BusinessJournalDaily.com. 3 minutes with is brought to you by Farmers National Bank.
Who's the only local bank with a mobile mortgage app? Farmers. Download the app to contact your lender, calculate payments, securely scan and upload documents, and check the status of your loan. Fiercely local, fiercely loyal, Farmers.
It is such a patently absurd story that people can't help but want to be part of it. I feel like this is one of those instances. Everybody has heard of it. I mean, even people who aren't from Cleveland, even people who aren't baseball fans have heard of it. And I feel like it resonates with a certain number of people. And it kind of feeds into, you know, there was this idea that Cleveland was a really tough town in the 1970s. And this kind of really feeds into that. The Indians, I think, had their first nickel beer night in 1971. And it had gone on without incident until this day in June. And as you might have surmised, that's because there were some extenuating circumstances. The Indians were playing what turned out to be a heated rival, at least in the moment. If you're one of those people who believes that kind of thing, it was a full moon as well that night. It was the beginning of June, so school was letting out and the local colleges were letting out as well. And of course, beer was 10 cents a cup. It actually turned into a really interesting game. The Rangers were leading 5-1, I believe after six. Going into the bottom of the ninth, it was 5-3. Manager Ken Asperani sent up three straight pinch hitters. Every one of them got a hit. And all of a sudden, the game was tied at five, and it really looked like the Indians might pull out the win. A couple of fans ran out into the outfield, and one of them tried to take Jeff Burrows' cap. And the fan fell down, and Jeff Burrows fell down. And Billy Martins saw Jeff Burrows fall down, and the field was crowned at the, so he didn't really get a full view of everything that happened, but he saw enough, grabbed a bat out of the bat rack, and led his team onto the field in what has been described to me as the charge of the Light Brigade. So the Rangers ran out onto the field, and they said, our guy's in trouble, we gotta go help him. Now the Indians are watching all this, and they said, hey, this could be real trouble. We should probably run out and help the Rangers. So then the Indians ran out onto the field. Ken Asperani, who was the manager of the Indians at the time, said, I felt like my 25 and Billy's 25 could take care of anything. I'm not sure he was right, because before too long, everybody ran onto the field. You know, one of the appeals of going to sporting events is that you're going to see something that you might never have seen before. And sometimes that's the comically absurd moments as well. But if you're going to see anything on a scale like this, I mean, I don't know. I don't think so. But, you know, I always have the capacity to be wrong. Because part of it, too, is a generational thing. I mean, for fans in the 70s, it was 10 cent beer night. For fans in the 2000s, it was Bottlegate. For fans now, I don't know what it's going to be, but I can't say never. The book is called Weird Moments in Cleveland Sports. It is available everywhere that fine literature is sold. And it is, as the title indicates, a collection of the weird moments in Cleveland sports from the 1800s almost to the present day.
BusinessJournalDaily.com. 3 minutes with is brought to you by Farmers National Bank.
Who's the only local bank with a mobile mortgage app? Farmers. Download the app to contact your lender, calculate payments, securely scan and upload documents, and check the status of your loan. Fiercely local, fiercely loyal, Farmers.